We're joined today by State Representative Eugene DePasquale from York. And Representative, you have introduced a bill in light of the Penn State scandal concerning open records. Why do we need to make a change?
First of all, it's House Bill 2051. And right now, under Pennsylvania open records law, in 2008, we did a dramatic rewrite of the state's open record law, made it significantly better, and put the burden on the government to show why something wasn't a public document as opposed onto the public to show why something wasn't. So really made big progress in openness and transparency in state law. However, the four state-related universities, which are Penn State, Temple, Pitt, and Lincoln University, were exempted from the law. I believe we need to change that, which is why I introduced House Bill 2051 to remove that exemption so they would have to comply with the open records law as the other state universities and every other state agency does.
And these universities receive large sums of money from the state, but so far they have been excluded.
Yeah, correct. Penn State alone gets over $250 million in state funding. The others, less than that, but still a significant amount of money.
And you think that the public, because of that amount of money, should really have more transparency, more idea of what's going on at those schools?
Especially with that going on. You know, look, if they didn't get the state funding, certainly I could understand the argument of not having them part of the state open records law. But with that funding, I think it is really necessary, especially considering what's happened recently, that not that it would change people's private behavior, or at least the allegations that are out there, but when it comes to what is happening with the money at the university, making sure that it is used for the students, you know, to pay for the professors and the academic buildings and nothing else. That is critical.
What kind of support are you getting?
We have 35 co-sponsors to the legislation right now, so adding myself, that's 36, and a couple other members have agreed to support it since that introduction, so we're at about 40 just, you know, that have verbally said it. I'm sure that if we get a vote on this, it'll pass.
Very interesting. Thank you, State Representative Eugene DePasquale, for joining us.